Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Sunday of the 23rd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. You are just, O Lord, and your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die, and you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us joyfully sing psalms to him.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massah in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law, the commandments. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not kill. You shall not steal. You shall not covet. And whatever other commandment there may be, are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault, between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today, I think it's very important for us to see, you know, how the Lord now highlights in today's Gospel, no, the communal aspect of our faith. So that's what I'd like to invite you to reflect on, no, which I think is a very important quality or characteristic of our faith, which is a communal or a communitarian faith, no? As some people say, but nobody goes to heaven alone, no? But let's just take a look at three things, no, that the Gospel reminds us of in terms of the communitarian aspect of our faith, no? Number one is that sin and reconciliation is really a sin against the community, not just against an individual, but against the community. And therefore, consequently, the process of reconciliation and forgiveness and healing is also a communal process, no? Then the second point is when the Lord, you know, very, very clearly promises, no, if you agree on what to ask for, then my Father will grant it to you, no? So again, that communal prayer. Then the third point to reflect on this Sunday is when the Lord says, no, very, very simply, but very powerful, no, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I will be present there, no? So these three points about the communal aspect of our faith, no? First, about the nature of sin, no? You know, there's a saying in Filipino which says, ang sakit ng kalingkingan ay ramdam ng buong katawan, no? And I think that very beautifully explains, no, how a sin against one person is actually a sin against the community. There's a certain disruption, no, in the life of the community, no, and I think that is something that we should consider, no. It also tells us that, you know, not because an injustice, for example, is done against one person, doesn't mean that we are not concerned, no. But I think an injustice done to an individual member of the community is an injustice done to us, no. So, you know, there is always that communal aspect, no, of sin, of injustice. And that's why even the entire process of healing and reconciliation becomes also a communal process. No? That's why at the beginning of every Mass, we begin with a communal penitential service. In fact, as I shared with you before, confession before began with a communal confession. No? And in the seminary, we had what you call the culpa, no? Wherein someone admits or says sorry before the community of his shortcomings, no? So I think that first point, no, the communal aspect of sin and forgiveness, no, which I think is something that we must seriously, no, take to heart, no. And then the second point about the communal aspect of our faith is very straightforward promise of the Lord, no. If you agree on what to pray for as a community, my Heavenly Father will give it to you. That's why, no, during this past 3 years, no, going on 4 of the pandemic, you have a lot of prayer groups coming together. You have a lot of rosary groups praying for healing, no, praying for an end to the pandemic. And I think for me that is a very beautiful blessing, if you wish, no, of this pandemic, that we have learned to pray together again. And, you know, and I've heard so many families sharing when I meet people they share with me how they have gone, how they are going to Mass again as a family because of the pandemic. Remember, just recall during the first year of the pandemic when the lockdown was very strict, no? And there's very minimal movement. And people would go to Mass online or through television or the TV masses. But at the same time, that became a source of the family coming together, of the family praying together. Again, no, something that we must cherish, no, and really look at, no. And a grace that we must continue to nurture, no. A very bold promise of the Lord. If you agree on what to ask, my Father will give it to you. And then the last point, no, again, very beautiful, very plain, but for me, the source of such great consolation. Where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them. The presence of Christ. And that is also the beauty of the Mass, no? We always come together as a community. We pray together as a community. We confess our sinfulness against each other and we confess to one another, no? And I think because of that, the Mass is such a beautiful moment of Christ's presence, no? So today, let us pray for this. Let us reflect on this beautiful reminder to us of the communal aspect of our faith. Pag nilaya natin to, no? Nasabi nga, di ba, may kasabihan na walang nagpupunta sa langit na mag-isa. Dahil ang ating pananampalataya ay isang pananampalataya bilang isang komunidad, no? Una sa lahat, makita natin sa Ebanghelyo na ang kasalanan laban sa isang tao ay kasalanan sa buong komunidad. Di ba nga, yung ang sakit ng kalingkingan, ramdam ng buong katawan. Na merong masasabi natin na medyo merong napuputol o nasusugatan sa komunidad pag merong pagkakataon ng kasalanan. Halimbawa, ang kawalan ng hustisya. At makita rin natin, sabi nga ng Panginoon, no, kaya dapat din ay ang ating paghilom at pagpapatawad ay isang masasabi natin aktibidad ng komunidad, no. At yung pangalawang punto tungkol sa komunidad ng ang pagiging isang pananampalataya na nakaugat sa komunidad na ang ating pananampalataya ay sabi ng Panginoon, pagka kayo'y magkasundo kung ano'y pagdadasal, bibigay sa'yo ng Ama ko 'yon. So itong tinatawag nga natin pagdarasal bilang isang komunidad or communal prayer. Di ba nga, itong nakaraang pandemya, ang daming mga, kahit online, ang daming mga rosary groups na nabuhay, ang daming mga nagdunobina sa isa't isa, ang daming muling nagsimba bilang isang pamilya, no? So itong pangalawang pangako ng Panginoon, no? At yung pangatlo at huli, napakapayak, pero palagi ko, dito lahat nagmumula ito. Sabi niya, kung saan kayo ay nagtitipon sa aking ngalan, naroon ako. Ito yung misa natin araw-araw, ano? Nagtitipon tayo sa pangalan ng Jesus, no? Lahat ng ating pagtitipon bilang isang komunidad ng panalangin, paano tayo nagsisimula? Sa ngalan ng Ama, ng Anak, at ng Espiritu Santo. So lahat ng panahon ng ating pagtitipon, lalong-lalo na ang Santa Misa, sapagkat nandun din sa Santa Misa ang ating pag-amin ng ating mga kasalanan sa isa't isa. At ang paghingi natin ng pagpapatawad bilang isang komunidad. At gayon din, di ba, bawat misa meron tayong special intention na hinihingi bilang isang sambayanan. So today, let us relish, no? And let us recapture the beauty of the communal aspect of our faith and the beauty of the Mass as one of the most beautiful coming together as a community. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
God our Father is generous and patient with us despite our sins and failings. He wants us to be the same to our brethren in sin and error. With confidence we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Give the Pope, bishops, priests, and deacons a heart that reaches out to sinners, so that they may be effective ministers of reconciliation. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all of us gathered here in the Eucharist see the wisdom in the words of St. Paul today. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Move judges, soldiers, and policemen, and those working in rehabilitation centers to temper justice with love and to always respect the inviolable rights of persons. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. And blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer a prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that you may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, we'd as I promised, I'd like to give you the total now of our collection the past week. No, this past week we received donations of 470,702 pesos and 29 centavos, which brings our total collection or donations for the year to 30,305,699 pesos and 30 centavos. Maraming salamat for your continued support. And also please consider joining our annual giving fund, the Ale Kapwa Expanded Fund, no? 500 pesos a year. And then also, please join us for Proyecto Pilipino. It's showing in YouTube, the Conscience Collective YouTube channel. No? Of course, Journeys of Hope after this, and also in my prayer channel. So maraming salamat po, and have a good Sunday. Have a prayerful and blessed Sunday. Thank you po.
Lindol, pagputok ng bulkan, bagyo,
nakulang po ng video ng habang tinatangay,
baha,
malakas din ang agos ng tubig niyan eh, madadala ka talaga. Instincts nga na kapag siguro may nangangailangan ng tulong.
Lahat ng ito, madalas natin maranasan at lahat ng ito, kailangan nating sama-samang lampasan.
Sa alay para sa katugunan sa kalamidad, pinapatatag at pinapalakas ng Caritas Philippines ang kakayanan ng mga social action centers sa paghanda at pagtugon sa kalamidad at sa mga emergency situation. Ginagabayan natin sila para makarecover at sa rehabilitation doon sa kanilang community.
Relief packages, wash o water sanitation and hygiene, shelter, livelihood, community formation, capacity building activities. Ito ang mga tulong na ibinigay ng Alay Kapwa.
Itong nakaraang taon, mahigit kumulang sa 200 communities na o 650,000 families o 3.2 million individuals na ang ating natulungan. Sa inyong patuloy na suporta, patuloy din ang Caritas Philippines na makatulong sa marami pang komunidad.
Kapit-bisig sa anumang trahedya.
Ito ang ating Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa.